Unit 3. Executive. The preamble of the Constitution of India declares India a sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic republic. The president is the supreme head of all the constitutional wings of the state. One example, the legislature, executive, judiciary and armed forces. President. The president is the head of the Indian state. He is the first citizen of India and acts as the symbol of unity, integrity and solidarity of the nation. Qualification and election of the president. Article 58 says, 1. No person shall be eligible for election as president unless he is a citizen of India, has completed the age of 35 years, is qualified for election as a member of the Lok Sabha. Article 52 of our constitution lays down that there shall be a president of India. Article 53 lays down that the executive power of the union shall be vested in the president and shall be exercised by him directly or indirectly. Further, Article 52 provides that the nomination of a candidate for election to the office of president must be subscribed by at least 50 electors as proposers and second by another 50 electors of the electoral college. This amount will be forfeited if the candidate does not secure 1/6 of the votes polled. The president is elected not directly by the people but by members of the electoral college consisting of the elected members of both the houses of parliament, the elected members of the legislature assembly of the states, the elected members of the legislative assemblies of the union territories of Delhi and Pondicherry. Electoral quota is equal to total number of valid votes polled in the election by number of electors to be elected plus 1. Entitlement to the president. He is entitled without payment of rent to the use of his official residence, the Rashtrapati Bhavan. He is entitled to such emoluments, allowances and privileges as may be determined by the parliament. Impeachment. Article 61 of the Constitution lays down a detailed procedure for the impeachment of the president. For the impeachment of the president, first charge for impeachment has to be made in either House of the Parliament by a resolution signed by at least 1/4 of the total number of members of the House and moved by giving at least 14 days advance notice. Term, impeachment and succession. Term. Article 56 says that the president shall hold office for a term of 5 years from the date on which he enters upon his office. If the vacancy occurs due to resignation, removal or death, then election to fill vacancy should be held within 6 months and the vice president acts as the president until a new president is elected. Further, when the sitting president is unable to discharge his functions due to absence, illness or any other cause, the vice president discharges his functions until the president resumes his office. In case the office of the vice president is vacant, the Chief Justice of India, or if his office is also vacant, the senior most judge of the Supreme Court acts as the president or discharges the functions of the president. Functions and powers of the president. Vast are the functions and powers of the president. He convenes the parliament, addresses and prorogues the same. He nominates 12 members of eminence in different fields to the Rajya Sabha and 2 Anglo-Indian members to the Lok Sabha. He enjoys veto power over non-money bills of the parliament and can send money send back non-money bills for reconsideration of the parliament. He can convene joint sessions of Rajya Sabha and Lok Sabha. He can promulgate ordinances for a period not exceeding 6 months. He can also has veto powers over certain state legislations. He prompts and facilitates the institution of Council of Ministers headed by the Prime Minister and ensures that the Council of Ministers enjoy the support of the majority in the Lok Sabha. The President alone installs the ministers and distributes portfolios to them. He can also dismiss the ministry if he feels that the ministry does not enjoy the majority support in the Lok Sabha. He nominates members to various constitutional bodies, including the judiciary, armed forces, and diplomatic corps. The President enjoys enormous powers during the periods of emergencies, can suspend any law, can dissolve ministries and legislatures for specified periods. He can commute capital punishments. The official residence of the President of India is the Rashtrapati Bhavan, situated at Delhi. Fact: the emergency powers of the President of India are specified in Part 28 of the Indian Constitution. Tamil Nadu, Karnataka, Punjab, Jharkhand, Jammu and Kashmir, and many other states have been under President's rule. The country's ambassadors and high commissioners are his representatives in foreign land. The President causes the presentation of audit report before Parliament. On the pattern of the Constitution of USA, the Indian Constitution provides for the office of the Vice President of India, Article 63. The Vice President of India occupies the second highest office in the country. Qualification. To be eligible for election to the office of Vice President, A. Candidate must be a citizen of India. B. Must have completed age of 35 years. C. Must be eligible for election as a member of the Rajya Sabha. And D. Must not hold any office of profit. In this connection, provisions similar to those relating to the President's apply. Terms of office. The Vice President is elected for a term of 5 years. He can voluntarily resign from his office before the completion of his term of office by writing to the president. He may also be removed from his office if a resolution to that effect is passed by the Rajya Sabha by an absolute majority of its members and agreed to by the Lok Sabha. However, 14 days have to be given to move such resolution. Functions and duties. The Vice President is the ex officio chairman of the Rajya Sabha, Article 64 of the Indian Constitution. He presides over the meetings of the Rajya Sabha. As the presiding officer of the Rajya Sabha, his functions and powers are similar to those of the Speaker of Lok Sabha. Article 63 to 70 of the Indian Constitution deal with Vice President. Make a presentation on the above. He described Prime Minister as primus inter pares, first among equals, and keystone of the cabinet arch. He said the head of the cabinet is primus inter pares and occupied a position which, so long as it lasts, is one of the exceptional and peculiar authority. Lord Morley. Executive. The Constitution provides for a collegiate executive. One example, Council of Ministers under the chair members of the Prime Minister. Meaning, a body of persons having authority to initiate major policies, make decisions, and implement the basis of the Constitution and laws of the country. There are two important organs of the Union Government. The Union Legislature or the Union Parliament, the Union Executive. In the previous unit, you have learnt about the Union Legislature. Let us now deal with Union Executive. You should remember that Articles 52 to 78 in part 5 of the Indian Constitution deal with union executive? Appointment. The Constitution does not contain any specific procedure for the selection and appointment of the Prime Minister. There is no direct election to the post of the Prime Minister. Article 75 says the Prime Minister shall be appointed by the President. Functions and position. The first and foremost function of the Prime Minister is to prepare the list of his ministers. He meets the President with this list and then the Council of Ministers is formed. Prime Minister's office. Meaning, being the head of the government and the real executive authority, the Prime Minister plays a very vital role in the politico-administrative realm of our country. In order to fulfill his responsibilities, the Prime Minister is assisted by the Prime Minister's office. PMO. The Prime Minister's office is an agency meant for providing secretarial assistance and advice to the Prime Minister. It is an extra-constitutional body which offers important role in the top-level decision-making process of the Government of India. The Prime Minister's office has the status of a department of the Government of India. The Prime Minister's office came into existence in 1947. Till 1997, it was called Prime Minister's Secretariat, PMS. The Prime Minister's office is headed politically by the Prime Minister and administratively by the Principal Secretary. Central Council of Ministers. Article 74th of the Constitution lays down that there shall be a Council of Ministers with the Prime Minister as the head to aid and advise the President, who shall in the exercise of his functions act in accordance with the advice of the Council of Ministers. That means there shall always be a Council of Ministers. The President accepts the advice of the Council of Ministers. The Council of Ministers consists of three categories of ministers, namely Cabinet Ministers, Ministers of State and Deputy Ministers, while the Cabinet Ministers are involved in policy decision making. The other two categories have mere administrative responsibilities. The difference between them lies in their respective ranks, emoluments, and political importance. At the top stands the Prime Minister, the supreme governing authority of the country. Appointment of the Council of Ministers. Under Article 75th of the Constitution, the Prime Minister is appointed by the President and other ministers are appointed by the President and the advice of the Prime Minister. Introduction. Articles 153 to 167 in Part 6 of the Indian Constitution deal with the state executive. The same pattern of parliamentary form of government is followed in the states. Part 6 of the Constitution, which deals with the government in the states, is not applicable to the state of Jammu and Kashmir, which enjoys a special status and has a separate constitution of its own. Article 370. The Governor. Provision for Governor. Article 153 of the Constitution lays down that there shall be a governor for each state. Normally, there will be a governor for each state, but the Constitution Amendment of 1956 makes it possible to appoint the same person as the governor for two or more states. Appointment of the Governor. The Governor of a state is appointed by the President of India. Article 155. Is a citizen of India, has completed the age of 35 years, does not hold any other office of profit, is not a member of Parliament or state legislature. Term of office and position. The prescribed term of office for the Governor is 5 years, but he holds office at the pleasure of the President. Article 156. He may be removed by the President at any time. The Governor is the executive head of the state government. The executive powers of the Governor are to be exercised by him either directly or through officers subordinate to him. One example, ministers. Article 154. All executive actions are taken in his name. The Governor is a part of the state legislature. Article 168. So he has legislative powers. His legislative powers cover the following. Under Article 213, the governor may promulgate ordinance during the period when legislature is not in session. However, for the continuation of such an ordinance, it has to be approved by the state legislature within 6 weeks from the reassembly of the legislature. The governor has judicial powers. His judicial powers cover the following. He determines the questions of appointments, postings, promotions, etc. of subordinate courts. One example, district courts and municipal courts. He may be consulted by the President of India while making appointments of the judges of the High Court. The governor has the power to pardon, suspend, remit or commute the sentence of any person convicted of an offence against any law relating to a matter to which the executive power of the state extends. President's rule. The governor has no emergency powers to meet the situation arising from external aggression or armed rebellion, but he has the powers to make a report to the president that the government of the state cannot be carried on in accordance with the provisions of the Constitution, Article 356, thereby inviting the president to assume to himself in the functions of the government of the state or any of them. Each state has an advocate general who is an official corresponding to the Attorney General of India and having similar functions for the state. He is a person who is qualified to be a judge of a high court and he is appointed by the governor. Council of the Ministers headed by the Chief Minister. Position of the Chief Minister. The Chief Minister is the head of the Cabinet and the Council of Ministers. In practice, he is the real executive head of the state. As per Article 164(1) of the Constitution of India, the Chief Minister of a state shall be appointed by the Governor of the state. He acts as the sole channel of communication between the Council of Ministers and the Governor. He communicates to the governor all the decisions of the cabinet relating to administrative and legislative proposals. State Councils of Ministers. Introduction. Article 163(1) of the Constitution of India provides that there shall be a Council of Ministers headed by the Chief Minister to aid and advise the governor in the exercise of his functions except when he is required by the Constitution to act in his discretion.